Hi everyone, thanks for watching News to Go. On this Tuesday, we are waking up in the early part of the day to sunshine, a few high clouds, and a cold start to this morning. Temperatures everywhere are in the 30s. It's going to take a few minutes for that to warm up, but by the noon hour, northwest Arkansas should be in the upper 40s. Later in the day, the high is going to be 50 degrees, and during this time of the year, we tend to set our afternoon high in the early part of the afternoon. So that's why you don't see the 50 right here, because by 4 o'clock, we're already starting to cool down. Same situation in the River Valley, starting the morning in the 30s by 8 o'clock, 43, noontime temperature 54, and a high today of 55.
And today we could find out if a law official will lose his job. Scott County Deputy Prosecutor Tom Tatum was charged over the weekend with driving while intoxicated. The 74-year-old was not required to post bond and left the jail about an hour later. Tatum is the father of Scott County Prosecutor Tom Tatum II. A warrant will be issued for a repeat offender. The Bentonville District Court says Jo Jackson missed her court date Friday. She is charged with public intoxication. Previously, she was convicted in the death of a construction worker in 2011. And arrested three times last year alone on DWI charges. Today, the Maggie House will open their doors to the governor and the public for a tour. 4D29's Pedro Rivera will tell us more about this event.
Governor Asa Hutchinson, he'll be here for a tour, but once that is done, you'll get your chance to see what Maggie House is really like. You know, they really want to make this place a home, so don't think about it as a facility, but four separate apartments, and this is one of them you're standing in right now. You can take a look here at the living room here. The big TV, the Christmas tree, all this furniture was donated by people here in the community, and local businesses as well gave them this. Now, I want to show you what one of the bedrooms looks like over here. Now, they have some bedrooms that fit two kids. This one is a single bedroom for a boy. You can see the bed here, the cabinets they have. It was all given to them. They got some money and were able to buy this from local donations and church groups here in the community. Now, the thing that makes this place very special is they want to make you feel like you're at home here for each one of the kids, because unlike other places that only keep kids for around 30 to 45 days, kids will be living here for a year up to 16 months, so a very long time. Now, Family Ministries, they've put the Maggie House together to help kids in seven counties in the River Valley looking to keep their lives on track.
And our goal is to provide a safe, secure, loving environment for these children who are, through no fault of their own, find themselves in the custody of the state. And the state needs a place to put them.
And their goal is to move in the kids on December 9th. And there's a lot more to see and a lot more to learn about the Maggie House. So you can come today at 1:30. The governor will be here. They'll have the ribbon cutting. You can walk around and ask all the questions you need. In Charleston, Pedro Rivera, 4D29 News.
And right now there are more than 4,000 children looking for a foster home, with around 950 of those kids being from the River Valley. Thank you for watching News to Go. I'm Yuna Lee. Have a great Tuesday.